This is a question from a person who has received dozens of full body x-rays and is wondering if there's anything that can be done to reduce or eliminate the accumulated radiation in the body. And certainly there are quite a few things one can do. First of all, make sure you avoid future exposures such as from mammograms, which are turning out to be a leading cause of cancer of the breast, and other forms of radiation that are more often given for reasons that don't require such diagnostic approaches. However, the once you have accumulated a certain amount of radiation, there are a number of things you can take internally or externally. You can take baths that are utilizing hydrogen peroxide, borax. It's a good combination to use, or bentonite clay in the bath. If you cannot take a full bath with bentonite clay, then at least take a couple of foot baths, which can also pull radiation because of their metallic nature, their ionic nature, that they literally pull radiation out through the bottom of the feet. Now, there's zeolite clay, or known as zeolite, which is very useful to decontaminate the body, and they have been used in instances where exposure to nuclear power plants had created radiation poisoning. So zeolite, Z-E-O-L-I-T-E, is very useful, and I put that on top of the list. The green clays are also very useful. Green French clay, which is more prevalent in Europe. Then there's baking soda, which is a very effective way of eliminating radiation, particularly from the kidneys. So it can be taken internally for a while. I would suggest no longer than 2 to 3 weeks. Even a half a teaspoon full a day and some water will help to decontaminate the body from radiation. Then there's boron. Boron is quite effective and has been shown to eliminate radiation. And besides that, there are obviously certain foods which can help with removing radiation, and that's anything from brown rice to seaweed, kelp. Kelp has been definitely shown to help with radiation problems. Miso soup, which is very popular in Japan. That is very helpful for people with radiation problems. Pumpkin turns out to be quite effective too, and pumpkin seeds, which you can find in most stores. Spirulina, which is a green-blue algae type, which also catches radiation and eliminates it from the system. Wheatgrass, some people do wheatgrass juicing. I recommend to do that only for a couple of days in a row, and then give it a break for a couple of days so that you don't get overexposed to the antibodies, plant antibodies, which are quite toxic. They can irritate or cause issues with the immune system that could lead to allergies to those particular antibodies. So there are some herbs as well which are pretty useful: cilantro, basil, sweet basil, and rosemary, a very popular herb, which is also known to diminish radiation accumulation in the body. Ginger is a very popular food that can be added to cooked food or salads in grated form, very effective for radiation. Then some people like alfalfa sprouts. If it's not genetically modified, then yes, go ahead with that. It has also shown benefits. And olive oil is a very good thing to add, because olive oil has been shown to transport radiation out of the body too. Anything that is green, green leafy vegetables, very good. The cruciferous vegetables like broccoli are very effective scavengers of radiation. And the other thing that has been shown to be quite effective is eating apples. So the old saying, an apple a day keeps the doctor away, this applies also to keeps the radiation away. So it's a good protective measure you can take on a day-to-day basis, have an apple a day, and that keeps the radiation away. I hope this is helpful to you, particularly who has had undergone major radiation poisoning, and that's a serious issue nowadays, because we don't just get radiation from medical technologies, but also from the atmosphere, from the, contamination from the experiments that are being done in various places underground and above ground, and nuclear waste material making its way into the water lines and waterways and into the soil, and from there into our food supply. And so it's good to eat foods that are immune, first of all, to radiation, and to remove radiation once it has occurred in our body. Thank you.